Hey guys, one of the last things I wanted to show you are the symbols. I use symbols to make these sesame seeds, and then we have just the roughen tool. I briefly mentioned the roughen tool last time, and I just wanted to go a little more into that because so you have a piece of lettuce that looks like this. We got to use roughen. So let's use like a nice like romaine color. And then we'll just select that. And when we go to distort, where's distort? And roughen, you'll see how much it works. So that looks pretty good already there, actually. That's some decent lettuce. If you had that as a side profile under your bun, put this on top. Sorry, I've got to click on this, and the sesame seeds are on top. So actually, I want to send the lettuce to the back. So we'll send this back. No, I want to send that to the back. Send all the way to the back. Not sure what's going on here. They should be the same layer. Send to back. I don't understand. Well, let's bring this to the front. Something's going on. This is weird. Why is this on the back? All right. I'm just going to undo till I started messing with that and we'll see what happens. Okay, so let's redo our roughen. Right, now let's move it where we're peeking out from under the bun. I'd like to make this a little bigger. Yeah, so we get some lettuce hanging off and we'll send this to the back. Really not sure why it's doing that, but if this were my project, I'd help you figure it out. Worst case scenario, you could just make this on a different layer. So let's see, what layer is this on? That's layer 10. This is on layer Stonehenge, that's why. So I wanna, that's why. Always check what layer you're using. So I wanna send this into layer 10. So now when I put this on, I can send to the back. There we go. And we can put the bun on top. So now that looks pretty good. That looks like some lettuce. I put these sesame seeds in there as well. So let's just delete all these. So that doesn't look great. Also, the problem is they're all facing the same way. So how did I create these sesame seeds? Let's just delete these. We'll just hide them for now. That's fine. So we don't want to be working in Stonehenge anymore. We're going to work all in layer 10. Yeah, this sesame seeds in layer 10. So what I did is this came in real small and I created an ellipse and then a triangle. So I'll show you what I did over here. Let's go in this space over here. So we'll go, little next to it. You can make it bigger and then smaller again. So that looks about right. And I want to use color. I want to use that color. That was a good color. So a little lighter than that. It's not bad. That's also a good color. So we'll have a slightly different color for this sesame seed. And then I went to the pen tool. And then I just created a triangle out like that. Always connect your points with the pen tool. And then I merge them. First, I want to make this triangle a little squatter. Maybe like that. Let's zoom in here and get more detailed. And yeah, I think that looks pretty good. So then I united them by selecting both and going to unite. So now it's one shape. And then I went in. Oh, you know what I did actually? This kind of comes in and out. What I actually did is I made this taller than it needs to be and then put it over. So what I'm looking at is how does it finish? So that looks pretty good. I want to make sure this is on the same line as that. So we'll make this taller that way. And now it looks pretty even. If it's a little off, that's fine because sesame seeds aren't exactly the same. But now we'll unite these and then I just trim this. That there could be a better way to do this, but I just made another shape, but instead of going along that line, I'm going along the line right there where it is tangent to the ellipse. And then I subtracted these with this minus. So then it kind of comes in at an angle. Then you can do the same thing over here. And subtract it. So select both. Now it kind of looks like it did before, but I'm not loving the way this looks. I would undo this. And then, right before we united it. And I'll make this a little longer. Yeah. So then we'll just do the same thing. Draw this from there to there. We got to unite these two first. Forgot that step. So we'll unite that and then we'll subtract this off. And then we'll subtract another one off. And it's okay that you have that tiny little dot. You're not going to be able to notice it from this far out because we're zoomed in quite a lot. If you want to get it even better, you can zoom in and we'll. We won't get that same mess up this time because you can line it up perfectly. And we'll subtract that out. So that you see that looks a lot cleaner. I want to get rid of that a little bit. So we can just make a little ellipse right here surrounding that, and then we'll just subtract it. There we go. All right, so now it's the decent shape. It doesn't look quite as good as that. I would use this one. This one has a sharper edge to it. And there could be better ways to do this. But what I did is I then made an ellipse. I kind of lined this up like that. And that looks pretty good. So then what I did is I just excluded this. So intersect, nope. I want to exclude. Yeah, so then it gets rid of the middle. And again, I really doubt this is the best way to do it, but this is how I figured out how to do it. So then I'm going to get rid of this shape. And so now that sharp edge is cut off, and I can add in a new ellipse. That's a similar size, and then we'll unite these again. So now it's got like a, let's make this taller. We want a soft ending. Yeah, still needs to be taller. And it's just like poking out. I don't want her to poke out. Let's zoom in some more. So if we pull it back more, I mean, you could keep working on this till it's perfect, but I just want to get kind of a soft ending. So let's go in soft edge, right? So that's going to be pretty close here. The issue is it keeps snapping to something I don't want it to snap to. You can turn off snapping, but I think that looks all right. Again, it's not as good as the one I did last time. I think that just looks better than this. But what we'll do is we'll unite. And now if you make it smaller, we'll see how it compares. The edge looks a little softer on that one, but I don't know. That one looks better to me. Anyways, what you can do is you can go to Window and go down to Symbol. And then you can add new. So this is going to be Sesame Seed 2 Electric Boogaloo. Static symbol. It's not a movie clip. It's a graphic. And you can save it. You see, then it pops in there. So if you wanted to use those sesame seeds on your burger, you can just drag them in. And there you go. But you see, they're all facing the same direction. So what we can do is then go to pattern. I'm gonna use my old symbol just in case, but we'll go to pattern and create a new pattern. So I'm thinking we just pop some of these sesame seeds in, and let's see how big they are. I want to go to my pattern. Yes, I think if you drag the symbol in, that doesn't work. So I'm going to paste in that sesame seed. And I'm going to zoom in, and I'm just going to copy in a bunch of these and drag them around different ways. And we'll do another one and drag that around here. And there. And here and there. And stop whenever you think you've got the right amount of sesame seeds. We'll drag this around that way. Then I'll stop with one. Oops. I like that. So let's go. I'm trying to zoom out. Let's go to this view and we'll just go with grid. Let's try hex. No, that doesn't look good. Hex by row. Try brick. Yeah, brick looks like a pretty good pattern. That looks random, doesn't it? All right, so we'll go with that. I like that a lot, and we'll say done. Wait, we didn't name it. Let's call this our sesame seeds. So I like that a lot. That looks really good. So now we could go to the, let's just delete these. And now we can make an identical copy of this bun. And we'll put this on here. But rather than using that fill, we'll go to our swatches and we'll pick out these new sesame seeds. And I think that looks great. Yeah, so something like that. If that looks a little sparse, you can go ahead and add more sesame seeds. We could just copy these and paste it in on top. You just do that. You want to make sure you bring that to the front, though, before you do that. So let's right-click, bring to front. We can just go to symbols and do it that way. And then we can drag some in. So let's drag in some of our new sesame seeds. They'll look a little different. Put some there. I don't know. Those look a little too weird for me. We gotta zoom in so we can turn these. So you could do that. I don't like that. They look too different. Let's add in our old ones. Let's just add in some old ones. Or you could go back in and edit your pattern. But I'm just trying to fill the gaps a little bit. So think that looks good. And we'll just rotate some of these so they're not completely the same. Yeah, there we go. So sesame seed bun done. Okay, so I just wanted to fix this bun a little bit. So what I did is I went to layers and I hid all the sesame seeds. I just copied this, moved it down here, made it a lighter color, and then put this on top. And now we have some depth. So what I'm going to do is unite these two. Yeah, see the issue with uniting is then it makes it the same color. So we're not going to unite those two. I'm just going to undo and then that does look pretty good as is actually. We could leave it here, or you could just clean up the edges like that. And then we'll make one over here. And then we can just zoom in and we'll just clean up those edges. So if I make, I just drag that path. If I were spending a lot of time on this, I would make that a straight line and then make these curves to match. But just for simplicity's sake, I'm going to go in and first of all, we're going to save this on our swatch. So going to make this a new color. And now we have that option. So when we go here, we can go to the new color. And now it's that bottom color. So do the same over here. And yeah, now we have our top bun. We could blend these two a little bit. Make it a little smoother of a transition. If we wanted to object blend. The issue is it's blending off in the middle too. So that's no good. Let's try that again. So I want to smooth the color. So that's a little better. Don't mind that. You could keep trying to make it look better if you wanted, but that's gonna do it for me. We can add these layers back in, all these sesame seeds, and we'll delete that one, and we'll just. What we want to do is drag this back over on top. But we want to move this up to the top, to the bottom. Yeah, so now the sesame seeds are back on top where they belong. And I think that's looking pretty good. We'll just drag our lettuce back over. our lettuce, we'll go there. And we need to drag this to the bottom. So now I got some lettuce peeking out. You can make it peek a little more out, like so. And yeah, that's looking great. I think if you just add a patty and some pickles and tomatoes, you are well on your way.